Hello, curious minds. We're back with yet another video for you to quench your thirst for all things space. So buckle right in because we're going on a flight to the stars. But before we carry on, make sure to press the subscribe button and do not forget to hit the bell icon to never miss out on any of our latest space niche videos. In this video, we'll be bringing you up to date with the recent developments in the crazy world of space. Let's talk about Elon Musk and how his company just announced the potential use of manganese-based batteries in Tesla, and this news hit the EV world very hard. When asked about the future of graphene-based cathodes, like many others in the industry, Musk said he was skeptical due to the complexity of making graphene, but did not rule out the possibility entirely. This conversation was brought forth in his recent speech to the Tesla Gigafactory employees at the grand opening of the company's new Gigafactory near Berlin. When he answered some of the questions and when asked about graphene-based batteries by an attendee, he voices an opinion and says they have interesting potential. Now, this brings back memories of Tesla's battery day in 2020 when he was revealing Tesla's 460-80 battery cell concept. Musk said that it's relatively straightforward to do a cathode that's 2/3 nickel and 1/3 manganese, which will allow them to make 50% more cell volume with the same amount of nickel. This shows us that the company has been exploring using more manganese in its battery cells for a while. However, at his recent address, the CEO does not elaborate beyond saying that Tesla was working on it, but it made it sound like it could be a solution along with nickel and iron-based chemistries. One of the pros of electric cars over gas cars is the ability to utilize various materials while producing battery cells. This is not only helpful if certain material is difficult to get to or too expensive, but it can also help battery makers with safety, efficiency, longevity, performance, and responsible and sustainable sourcing. However, current lithium-ion batteries are heavily dependent on cobalt, which is toxic, expensive, and usually mined unethically. In fact, the environment impact of cobalt mining may outweigh the reduced carbon footprint of driving an electric vehicle. Elon Musk has previously vowed to eventually fully eliminate cobalt from the batteries that Tesla uses, according to a Wired article from 2020, which plans for Tesla to produce its own cobalt-free batteries. Let's take a look at the battery that's currently being used extensively in that Tesla's called the LFP-4680. It was around October last year when Tesla announced that it was switching to LFP batteries for its standard range models, both Model 3 and Model Y. The reason it kept the cobalt batteries for the long-range trims is because of the lower energy density of LFP configurations. In order to get performance or very long range, you need a larger LFP battery. The main argument for LFP batteries often boils down to material availability and cost. Initial sourcing concerns centered around cobalt, which is a rare earth metal that's often mined in areas known for conflict and human rights violations. Moving away from such a fraught source made sense ethically and for business continuity. One way that scientists talk about battery life is by cycle lifetime, or how many times the battery can be charged and then discharged before its capacity falls below 80% of the original. Several studies show that LFP batteries have a cycle life of 2 to 4 times longer than NMC batteries. LFP batteries have a lower operating voltage per cell than other common lithium-ion batteries, which means that you might need more of them if you need a specific voltage. This means that LFP technology is not a one-size-fits-all solution. For heavy transport needs, LFP may not be as useful as cobalt-based batteries, since a higher workload may be needed. We know Musk plans for gradually reducing the carbon footprint a Tesla leaves behind, and hence can understand why Tesla would prefer to use LFP batteries instead of largely cobalt-based ones. However, they're not the long-term solution when we consider all the factors that make an EV efficient, smart, sustainable, and ethically sound. This need for all electronic vehicles to be ideally their best versions leads us towards the use of manganese instead of cobalt as the primary element, since most of the lithium-ion batteries that power electric cars today depend to some degree on cobalt, a less expensive and readily available alternative that was needed to save the day. A battery with a manganese-rich cathode is less expensive and also safer than one with the high nickel concentrations. The properties of electro materials are determinants of the electrochemical performance of the batteries. By virtue of prominent features of low cost, non-toxicity, and high voltage, magnesium-based electro materials have attracted increasing attention. Manganese has several advantages over elements currently used in EV batteries, including the price. The cost of nickel reached a peak of $45,000 per kilo and stabilized at $30,000 this month. In contrast, manganese has only reached a price of $10,000 per ton, and this is due to it being the 12th most abundant element on the planet. For manufacturers of lithium-ion batteries, this lower price point allows more funds to be allocated to refining the technology for safer, better-functioning products. Another factor to consider here is that while nickel and lithium are only found in some specific regions, manganese producers can be found on all continents. This prevents supply chains from being impacted due to regional disruptions like pandemics, wars, or political tensions. Manganese also benefits the companies in maintaining their ethical values. As we mentioned earlier, the mining of cobalt is extensive and unsafe due to the blasting technique used in its extraction. Several companies mining for manganese, on the other hand, have engineered safe mining techniques that protect the environment, workers themselves, and nearby populations in recent years. The only obvious downside to this great change would be that a high constant, high purity supply is needed to produce manganese batteries. If the quality of manganese varies or is low, batteries might not need or meet the safety, durability, and performance levels required by the EV industry. But don't worry, as this parameter can be regulated and perfected with research and implementation. Being the essential ingredient in making steel paired with the growing potential to save the lithium-ion battery industry from going downhill, manganese is showing itself to be a viable investment option for all those involved, suppliers and consumers. Hence, the one flaw we seem to have does not nearly outweigh the benefits of incorporating it. Several researchers have published papers on promising manganese-rich cathode batteries that could offer interesting options with a higher energy density than iron phosphate and potentially lower price than nickel-rich batteries. This indicates that the revolutionary idea of using manganese cathode-based batteries is not Tesla's alone, but other big companies have been eyeing this prospect and conducting research accordingly. In the case of Tesla, we know that manganese is already used in some battery chemistries, but it's not the prominent component of any of them. Elon Musk makes it clear that he's not expecting some crazy new battery format to revolutionize the EV industry overnight. That said, Tesla has certainly been playing around with different battery chemistries, and we're eagerly waiting to see what their extraordinary engineering brings to the table this time. With this, we have come to the end of the video. Congrats on having a great attention span. Let us know how excited you are about the new ventures of SpaceX down in the comments below. SpaceX, Tesla, doesn't matter. Sound off in the comments section. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed the video, make sure to like and subscribe for similar content. Until we meet again next time, take care.